my loves, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. Hi, hello, my name is Loey. Today's video has been on the back burner for me for months at this point, but it's really because I thought that this was going to be in tandem with a vlog. The Catacombs of Paris have been my absolute dream paranormal destination for years. That is the one place that is so truly on my bucket list, like have to do it before I die. And I had plans of going this year actually, until obviously everything got shut down with COVID-19 and quarantine. So it's still definitely something where I'm going to visit them in the future, and I cannot wait to take you guys along for that journey, whatever that winds up being. But I thought I might as well still talk about the catacombs themselves, because as I was looking into it the other night, having a bit of restless anxiety over being cooped up in the house for the last like year, I realized that there's not only so much information I did not know about the catacombs, but so many crazy myths, legends, ghost stories. So sit back, relax, get yourself a snack or a drink. I've got my coffee, and let's talk about the Paris catacombs. If you're not familiar with the Paris catacombs, you may at least be familiar with the movie As Above, So Below. One of my favorite horror movies of all time, it is of course set in the catacombs of Paris, and these underground tunnels that run through the entire city of Paris hold the remains of more than 6 million people. You heard that correctly. More than 6 million people are buried underneath the streets of Paris. Oh, dogs. Oh my God, they're so cute. They're so old. Oh, they have little white faces. Oh yes, you jump in that car, sir. I love them. So the catacombs themselves are only a small part of an entire underground quarry system that runs through Paris. These abandoned quarries, or basically mines, forgive me for my butchered French, but in French they are called carrières de Paris, and these are just a number of subterranean mines that run underneath Paris. The catacombs themselves are placed south of the Barrière d'Enfer. Whatever it is actually known as the Gate of Hell. Many of the bodies were not originally underground in these catacombs. They were actually buried in various cemeteries all across Paris. However, from what I was reading, in the 1700s, the city of Paris was becoming very concerned with the amount of space that the dead bodies were taking up. There were stories of wine going bad and milk curdling. Starting in 1786, covered wagons would transport bodies from Paris's cemeteries to these underground tunnels. Now, this seemed totally normal at the time and was really just an attempt to help with the overpopulation of Parisian cemeteries. However, in the 19th century, people became very fascinated by the thought of so many bodies being buried underground. At that point, the catacombs had been largely forgotten about and abandoned. And so, in the 1800s, people began holding private parties and events in these catacombs. In 1874, the catacombs became available for public visitation, and as of 2013, they are managed by a Parisian group which actually runs 14 other museums in Paris. So these catacombs, which contain a countless, unfathomable number of bodies underneath the surface of this incredible city, are undeniably a very fascinating topic. There's something so macabre and morbid about the thought of all of these dead bodies being buried underground, which is so difficult for living people to get into. Though human curiosity is strong and strange, a lot of what was happening in these catacombs is even stranger. So in 2004, Paris police were running a training exercise in a previously unexplored part of the Paris catacombs. According to Atlas Obscura, the police came across a sign that probably shouldn't have been there, saying building site, no access. Upon exploring further, they then came face to face with a camera that recorded the movement of anything walking past. When the police tried to investigate the camera further, a recording of barking dogs played back at them. Dumbfounded as to why this camera was in the middle of the Paris catacombs where no people should ever have been before, the police trudged on, only to find the unimaginable. Deep within the Paris catacombs, in an area thought to have been uncharted, was a movie theater. a full movie theater with a projector and film tapes of like classic noir films, as well as recent thriller movies. But it doesn't stop there. On top of all of that equipment was a fully stocked bar, a restaurant with tables and chairs, working power and phone lines, and electricity that was just illuminating this random movie theater in the middle of the Paris catacombs. I don't know that I'm properly explaining just how strange it would be to be in a movie theater under the streets of Paris that nobody knows about, surrounded by the bodies of 6 million people. The police left the catacombs that day dumbfounded. They returned 3 days later with members of the French Board of Electricity to try to figure out where the power lines were coming from. But as they went back through the cave, they were alarmed to find that there was no movie theater, no restaurant, no bar. The power lines had been cut and a single note was left lying on the ground. This note in French roughly translated to, "Do not try to find us." Can you even imagine what those people must have been thinking when they had seen this entire unthinkable movie theater, restaurant, bar in the Paris catacombs and returned and it was like no one was ever there? Now, that is entirely based in fact. That is a real event that did happen and was reported back in 2004. But there are also just a ton of myths, urban legends, some based in fact, some just kind of seeming like ghost stories within the Paris catacombs. So I'm gonna tell you about a few of those today. Back in the 1990s, a group of explorers were going through the Paris catacombs when they came across a video camera. Keep in mind that people were not recording on their cell phones like you and I do today, or even point and shoot cameras. Video cameras back then were camcorders and they were huge and bulky. Nobody was within sight of the video camera, so the group took it, and when they came back onto land and looked at the footage that was on the camera, alarmingly, it seemed to show somebody who had gotten lost within the Paris catacombs was running around, becoming more and more and more frantic, their breath becoming more anxious and labored as they continued to just walk through the catacombs endlessly. Looking over this description, I was obviously fascinated, but the best part about video stories, about video files, is that usually that has lived on until today. And to my absolute amazement, this clip is real and exists. This is not a Blair Witch Project-esque plug for a movie. This is a real tape that actually exists. I think that the origin of this could be debated, whether the people who found the tape planted it there themselves, or somebody was playing a prank, or perhaps, most disturbingly, somebody actually did get lost in the Paris catacombs and leave their camera behind to face a fate that none of us could ever be certain of. In this footage, you can see this person picking up a skull, examining bones, videotaping the walls and everything around them. And as the video goes on, they just get more and more and more anxious, more freaked out. At the very end of the video, something seems to startle them. They drop the camera and run away. The story behind this video is that this man got lost in the Paris catacombs and it drove him slowly insane, trying to find his way out of the incredible maze that is just those miles and miles of tunnels. But we can never know for sure because nobody has ever owned up to owning the footage, has ever talked about their story escaping the catacombs, anything like that. Now, that movie that I mentioned before, As Above, So Below, is supposedly inspired by this potential tragedy, which is crazy to think about. Another legend of the Paris catacombs are the voices that appear at midnight. Supposedly, if you somehow stay in the Paris catacombs after midnight, the walls will begin talking to you. And if you've looked at the Paris catacombs in any of the photos that I've flashed up so far, skulls and bones just line the walls. So apparently they begin to speak. And these disembodied voices encourage you to go deeper and deeper still into the catacombs until you get lost and have to stay with them forever. Maybe it's because I just watched Beauty and the Beast, but it feels very like Be Our Guest, like stay for dinner. Stay forever, who knows? So yeah, apparently the walls will begin talking to you and the spirits of all of those people will just tell you to stay forever. There's actually a sign outside of the catacombs that says, "This is the Empire of the Dead." And it truly must be. I cannot think of another place on earth that you can go to like that and just walk through and see the bodies of so many people whose graves were probably defiled for them to even be there, because these bodies were trudged through Paris on wagon, so that they could be moved underground so that the wine would stop spoiling and the milk would stop curdling. If any place in the world is haunted, I do believe it is the Paris catacombs. We don't know exactly how many bodies are in the catacombs, nor do we know exactly who is there, because all that we do know is that these graves were often dug up and the bodies were taken down. There are many prominent French men and women buried down below, but one of the bodies in the catacombs was not one that was dug up and placed there later. One of the bodies, specifically in the catacombs, was someone who actually perished within them. During the French Revolution, Philbert Aspert was a doorman at the Val de Grace Hospital. Philbert was on a mission to retrieve a certain bottle of liqueur from a wine cellar when he somehow stumbled his way into the Paris catacombs instead. It is said that he was likely intoxicated to have made this kind of mistake, but however he ended up there, he was in fact in the catacombs. And remember that this would have been in the late 1700s. This man had like a candle to guide his way through. It's believed that due to the potential intoxication and the single light from a candle, he became lost and confused. Eventually, when his candle blew out, he was trapped and never found his way out of the catacombs. His body was not discovered until some 11 years later, when catacomb explorers just happened to come across him. He was only able to be identified because of the hospital key ring on his belt. Now his body is buried within the catacombs in the very place where he died, with a small tombstone explaining the strange nature of his death. Now the legend states that every November 3rd, and I'm not sure why November 3rd specifically, I couldn't quite find out why that date. I don't know if it was supposedly the date that he died, since of course he was not found for like 11 additional years, but for whatever reason, on November 3rd, he haunts the Paris catacombs, trying to find his way out once again. While doing research for this video, I stumbled across an hour-long documentary, basically, from Amy's Crypt going through the Paris catacombs and ghost hunting. Now, this full video is a must-watch if you are at all interested in this topic. I definitely think it is a good pair to this video once you kind of know the history and everything behind it to then basically have your own guided walkthrough of the catacombs, as well as this ghost hunting segment within the video. It's very, very cool. I will have Amy linked down below. And me, being someone who is so obsessed with catacombs, Amy's video was fascinating in that she found candles and evidences of get-togethers and parties in the catacombs, graffiti and art on the walls in the parts that I don't think are generally very accessible for the public. But by far, the most alarming footage that Amy has are scenes from her paranormal investigation within the catacombs. At one point, as she is using a spirit box, she hears what sounds almost like a little girl or a woman making a kind of like small groaning sound.
Comment it's small? How did you die?
And then there is a deep growl from within the catacombs. The person with Amy said that their stomach may have growled, that could have been it, but still so weird to watch. Later on in the video, a different tool that she uses for her ghost investigation specifically gives her a French name. Now, whether that was someone who had passed away and was living in the caverns, or just a random name that was thrown out, we'll never know. But even more alarming, as Amy's paranormal investigation is interrupted by another group of people walking through the tunnels, the ghost app says Loey, which means him in French.
We keep going. Maybe stop recording.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop. Oh, Loey.
We just got a word, Loey?
L-U-I.
That's a name.
Was it warning Amy of the intruders coming close to the space where she was ghost hunting? Or was it referring to themselves, the ghost? I will, of course, have that linked down below if you guys wanna go and watch. It is a fascinating, fascinating video, and I'm a big fan of Amy's channel, but what do you guys think of this? I'm such a fan of the Paris catacombs history and all of these stories and myths and legends behind it. So I do so hope you all enjoyed this video. And if you want to see my eventual vlog through the Paris catacombs, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I love you very much and I will see you in my next video.